So let's say you have a ton of files on your Mac and you want to get organized. So here's an example with only 7 files. And let's say I decide I want to organize these, and I'm going to do that by creating folders. So I'm going to do File, New Folder, and I'm going to create Project A, and File, New Folder, and Project B. And I could organize them by saying, hey, here, these 3 go into Project A, these 3 go into Project B, and this one, oh no, this one is actually a file that's both Project A and Project B. So what do I do here? Create a new folder for both, put it in one and hope I remember it's there, or maybe create an alias. You know, it can get confusing. It's hard sometimes to organize things by putting them in a specific place and only that one place. So let's look at a better way to do it using tags. So instead of putting these files in individual folders, I'm going to assign tags to them. So I'm going to select these 3, and these are part of Project A, but I'm going to assign a tag to them by hitting this little tag button at the top, and I'm going to click red, and I'm going to assign these all the tag red. I'm going to hit return, and you can see they now have a red dot next to them. This one is part of Project B. I'm going to assign those to green. Great, so now I've got this file, and this is for both Project A and Project B. So I'm actually going to assign red and green to it. Now you can see I've got both dots there. So this is great, but all my files are still in this huge pile here. And imagine if there were hundreds of them instead of just these 7. But I don't have to worry about that because I don't need to look at them in a huge pile. I can actually, in the Finder sidebar here, look for tags, make sure I show it, and I can click on red to just see the red ones. So there's the 3 red ones and the one that's tagged both red and green. I can click green to see the ones tagged green, including the one tagged red or green. So I can go and look at the huge folder full of files, or I can just look at them based on the tags that they have. But I don't want these to be red and green. I want them to be Project A and Project B. I go to Finder Preferences, and under Tags, I can see the red and green and other ones that are there by default. I can actually select them, click again, and I'm editing. So now green could be Project B, and red can be Project A. And now I see them here listed as Project A and Project B. Those files are still there. They're still using red and green as the colors, but they're using those names. If I want to use the colors for something special, I can actually click the color here and change to a different color as well. So these are both project files. I can say, well, all my projects, I'm going to just use the color red. So now they're all red. And you can see, but I do see them as Project A, Project B. I can select it and I click the tags and I can see which one it is. This is the one I click and I can see they're both there. I can also click on one and do Command I and see the tags up at the top there. So there are a lot of different ways to access the tags. I can Control click and I could see the tags here, and you can see as you roll over them, tag A, B. Yeah, you remove the one that if it's already there and it's circled, you can see. So this one, if I select this here and I Control click, you can see these 2 are both circled. Project A, Project B, I can add another one to it. Lots of different ways to add and remove tags that can help you organize things. So tags are very versatile. You can set them up any way you want. You can have hundreds of tags or just a few. I want to show you one other thing here. You can search using tags. So in search up here, I can search for Project A, and it will come up and say tags Project A, and I'll just find it there. But I could also use search criteria here. I can press the plus button. I could say name matches. Instead of name, I can change that to other, search for tags, and say tags matches or is Project A. And then I could say also tags is Project B. It's only going to show me the intersection of those, so that one file that has both. But if instead I hold the Option key down and press what becomes 3 dots here, I can say if any of the following are true, and I can do the same thing here, is Project A tags is project B. And then I'll get rid of these two here at the top. So now I've got it set where any of the following are true. Tags is either project A or project B. And I get all of those. So imagine if I have 100 tags for 100 different projects, I can say, well, I want to see everything that's project A and B, but not all the other projects. So it'll combine them. And then once you do the search, I can hit save. And I can actually save this as a smart folder. So that I can get to it anytime I want. So I'll save it in that work folder here. I'll call it projects A and B. And now when I look here, I've got everything here. I've got this smart folder here. I go into that and that's where I can always see that. And that will update automatically every time I add something new to either project A or project B or both. It will appear in this smart folder. So yet another way that you can use tags to organize things and have them appear in more than one place at a time. It's a much more advanced way of organizing than simply putting everything into a single folder where it belongs.